Now, the Olympic Games have been inspiring stunning images and art through the years. Just look at these Olympic posters, Paris, 1924, and these classical images of athletes. They couldn't be more different from Munich in 1972 with its modern abstract art. And 2012 will be no different. It's the first time since 1972 that artists have been commissioned to create the official posters, so it only seems natural that they be unveiled here.
Culture runs alongside the Olympics. You know, London has, and Britain has, a lot more to offer than just sport, definitely.
Tracy Emin is one of 12 artists asked to paint posters for the Games. So what do you want people to take away when they see your poster?
I want people to smile and just feel kind of warm and feel that they're part of something and not excluded from something, because the previous posters were a little bit on the sort of macho fashion side, and I wanted to do something that was the complete antithesis to that.
For art historian Ghislaine Wood, the posters convey more than just an image.
Olympic posters provide a fantastic sort of snapshot. They really do provide a real insight into how posters communicate ideas at different points.
And it's not just sport that is depicted, but politics too.
And if we look at the Munich posters of 1972, there was a very conscious effort to change the look and feel of that Olympics. Fascist connotations of, say, Berlin in 1936 have been utterly changed to definitely sort of brand it as a modern, democratic event.
So what will stand out for London in 2012?
The Wolf Olin's logo was a very powerful element of the whole branding and design of the London Olympics. We look at Zaha Hadid's Aquatic Centre, a fantastic piece of contemporary modern design.
One of the most controversial signature buildings of the Olympic Park is the tower known as the Orbit. But the architect who worked on the project says it will be an unforgettable sight for visitors.
From afar, people in different parts of London will get glimpses of it. It is eclectic, it's unexpected, it's inventive. Whether you like it or you hate it, you will always see it as one of these eccentric British creations.